What is the best time for meals and why meal times matter? Welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Alema Health Matters. Is this your first time? I urge you to subscribe to my YouTube channel, like this video and also share. You can also comment on the comment section and share your views about this video. Don't forget to click on the bell so that you'll be notified every time I upload a new video. This episode objectives are: why meal times matter, the best times to eat breakfast, lunch and dinner, and lastly, choosing your meal times. Why meal times matter? Though many of us tend to feel like what we eat has a greater impact than when we eat, it's important to remember that our bodies digest food differently at various times of the day. Many of these daily fluctuations are related to circadian rhythm, the cycle that moderates our sleep-wake patterns over 24 hours. In other words, it's the body's internal clock, and it reacts primarily to changes in light. And we usually think of circadian rhythm as affecting how tired or awake we feel, but they also influence other physical, mental and behavioral processes in the body, including eating and digestion. Conversely, mealtimes influence circadian rhythm. Thus, our eating habits and circadian rhythm constantly interact. There are associations between circadian rhythms, mealtimes, weight status, and even insulin resistance, a hallmark of metabolic conditions like obesity and diabetes. Repeated disruptions to normal circadian rhythms, such as those that happen when we travel between time zones or pull an all-nighter, may increase your risk of developing a metabolic disorder. The best times to eat. Keeping a constant meal schedule from day to day is linked to weight loss, an increase in energy, and a reduction in metabolic risk factors for chronic diseases. Still, eating at the same time every day may not always be doable, so it's best not to take a one-size-fits-all approach to meal times. What's more, individual genetics affect much of how our bodies regulate circadian rhythms that interact with meal times. Thus, there is no single best mealtime schedule for everyone, and it may take some trial and error to discover the best mealtimes for you. Here are some guidelines to keep in mind when scheduling your mealtimes for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. The breakfast. Taken literally, breakfast is the first meal of the day during which you break your overnight fast. Scientists still debate just how important the timing of that meal is. Some people feel strongly about eating breakfast within the first few hours of rising, while others prefer to wait until later in the day when their appetites are higher to have their first meal. Each may have its own set of benefits. A few studies found that skipping breakfast may affect diet quality. More specifically, skipping breakfast may lead to eating more calories during lunch and less nutritious food overall during the rest of the day. What's more, consuming more calories during breakfast rather than later in the evening may benefit weight loss efforts. On the other hand, some research found that restricting the total number of hours in the day during which you eat specifically to 12 hours or less may also assist weight loss efforts and improve metabolic health overall. Keeping a limited meal window during the day is a type of intermittent fasting known as time-restricted eating. Lunch. In addition to eating a regular breakfast meal, studies suggest that an earlier lunch may help people lose weight, though it's important to note that individual genetic factors are also at play. Some newer research even suggests that an early lunch may contribute to a healthier microbiome, the collection of bacteria in the human gut and body that have significant effects on overall health. All in all, keeping the bulk of your calories intake in earlier hours of the day by having an earlier breakfast and lunch may benefit weight loss and metabolic health. The dinner. When it comes time for dinner, eating earlier in the evening and avoiding high calories meals just before bedtime or throughout the night may support better health outcome. One study in 8,000 adults associated eating late at night with dyslipidemia, high levels of fat in the blood, and a risk factor for chronic disease. Others have linked a later dinner with changes in body fat, weight gain, and the body's ability to digest sugar. These research findings often have to do with the hormone melatonin. Released at night, melatonin is one of the primary hormonal regulators of circadian rhythm and our sleep-wake cycles. As the body releases melatonin, it releases less insulin, which inhibits its ability to digest sugars like glucose. Thus, scheduling mealtimes too closely to when your body releases this hormone, especially late in the evening, is a risk factor for a chronic disease. Choosing your meal times. Though the best meal times will ultimately vary from person to person, there are some general suggestions for timing meals. Keep these three rules of thumb in mind when planning your meal times. Number 1. Eat earlier when possible. Many studies have linked earlier meal times to better health outcomes compared with eating late at night. Number 2. Limit your daily window of eating. Keeping your entire caloric intake for the day within a 12-hour time frame reduces the risk that digestion will interfere with your body's circadian rhythm. Thirdly, consider your circadian rhythm. Your body may not digest and process your meals as efficiently while it's also releasing melatonin hormone, specifically late in the evening or during very early morning hours. This is the last part of this discussion. I urge you to subscribe to my YouTube channel, like this video, and also share. You can also comment on the comment section. and share your views about this video. Don't forget to click on the bell. Thank you so much for watching.